One of the main features we've added to trakax Pro is the ability to crossfade media on the same track, allowing you to create your audio and video mixes quickly and easily. In both the trakax Pro version and the free trakax version, you're able to introduce fades at the beginning and end of the audio or video segment. Firstly, I'm going to show you how easy it is to crossfade two audio files on the same channel. This is a great way to make DJ mixes or mixes of your favorite songs. So I'm now going to drag in two audio files from the media browser and place them on the same channel. You can drag a file from the media browser directly on top of another file, but I'm just going to drag it on manually for demonstration purposes. I just want to draw your attention to the automatic crossfading icon in the mixing window toolbar. In the Pro version, this is defaulted to on. This means when audio, video and photographs are intersected, they'll be crossfaded. You can turn this button on and off. One word of note, audio will only crossfade with audio, and video and photographs will crossfade together. Now we'll crossfade the two tracks together. Simply highlight the second track and drag it onto the first segment. As you will notice, the segment snapping graphic will appear when the two files are exactly beside each other. As they begin to intersect, a white crossfade box will appear. This crossfade box indicates the length of the crossfade and the crossfade type, which is defaulted to linear. I'll now click play. As you can hear, the two files were crossfaded and beat matched at a global tempo of 127 BPM. You can click and drag the crossfade to extend it or decrease it. This simply means you're expanding or decreasing the size of one of the files. You can also click on each track to highlight the file, to see how much the audio file is crossfaded. As beat matching is not an exact science, this highlighting feature is very helpful if you need to realign beats which may be slightly off. You can change the default crossfade from linear to other fade types. Right click on the white crossfade box and select the fade type option in the menu. Here we will select very slow. As you can see, the fade type has changed shape within the crossfade box. In the free version of trakAxPC, automatic crossfades are not available, but you're able to fade between files on multiple tracks. Another new feature we've implemented is to create fades at the beginning and end of segments. To introduce a fade at the beginning of a clip, place the cursor at the beginning and top of the clip until you see the fade graphic appear. Once the graphic appears, click and hold the left mouse button and drag to introduce the fade. Expand it as much as you like. The end of the track works the same way. Again, you can right-click on the fade and select the fade type. Here we'll choose smooth and fast. I will click play and I'll solo each track so you can hear the fade. As you can see, you can fade quickly and easily between files with the minimum of fuss. In the Pro version of trakAxPC, you can automatically crossfade video and photos on the same channel the same way as audio. In this example, I'm going to introduce two pieces of video and a photo and crossfade them automatically. You can again adjust the length of the file to expand or decrease the fade. Right-click on the crossfade to change the fade type. With video, you can right-click on the crossfade box and introduce a transition. This will be covered in the video transition tutorial. In the free version, you can also fade videos and photos at the start and end of each file. This works the same as audio. I you can also adjust the fade of a text credit.